Hi, welcome to Volume 1 of The Cups and Balls. What do we mean when we say The Cups and Balls is a classic? Magic scholar John Rockerbomber defines classic with a handy acronym, SAVOR, which means, by the way, distinctive quality or property. That stands for simplicity, ageless, visualness, open, and recurring. Let's take a look at these words. Simplicity. In a classic, the props are simple and immediately understood. In the case of the cups and balls, the props are cups, balls, and a wand. These props are not only instantaneously recognizable, but everything that happens with them is easily understood. All actions are straightforward, the effects are direct, and there should be no confusion. Ageless. Classics survive through time and have historical continuity. Thousands of magicians in every era have taken the basic effect and developed countless variations. Yet the trick itself never loses its power to capture, hold, and amuse any kind of audience in any kind of venue, any place, any time. Visualness. This refers to the strong eye appeal of the effects. I'm talking about robust primary effects, vanishes, productions, penetrations, and transformations. These are perhaps the mighty four of the so-called 18 basic effects in magic. Open. Most classics aren't a closed system. They are an open system that permits variation, flexibility, interpretation. Because classics consist of analyzable components, they can be linked and unlinked in a great number of ways. This allows magicians, namely you, to freely improvise and tailor your own routine. My central goal as a teacher is to give you rudimentary parts or components, the vital tools, then show you how they are applied in an open system. Recurring. This refers to how effects which seem to have repetitive sequences actually work together to create a much more powerful cumulative effect. Here on Volume 1, we'll build a firm, solid foundation that will provide all the support you'll need to build a strong understanding and performance of the classic Cups and Balls.